Politico is reporting tonight that the president's embattled White House physician, Ronny Jackson, will not return to his old job as Trump's personal doctor. Now, this comes, of course, after a series of allegations that he drank on the job and gave out pills like candy. Again, allegations, and that he created a toxic work environment. These scandals previously, until last week, did not matter to the president. He still wanted him to be his pick. His VA secretary, but ultimately Ronny Jackson was forced to withdraw because of all of these allegations coming out in a flurry. Let's get right to the White House, to CNN's Boris Sanchez. And Boris, of course, Ronny Jackson was the primary physician for the president before the president nominated him to be VA. He's still in the White House medical unit as of now. My understanding is that when Ronny Jackson was nominated, that somebody else stepped up from the White House medical unit to be the president's primary physician, and that's going to stay that way. Ronny Jackson's not getting his old job back.
That is right, Dana. At least that's what Politico is reporting right now. CNN has reached out to multiple White House officials, not only for confirmation of the news, but also for an explanation, considering how much praise the president has heaped on Ronny Jackson. It is kind of surprising that he's not going to move back into his old role. The president clearly admires the admiral. Further, the president has gone as far as to threaten a Democratic senator, John Tester, because of his role in downing Jackson's nomination for VA secretary. The president spoke about this last night in Michigan. Listen to some of what President Trump said about Ronny Jackson last night.
Admiral Jackson started studying, and he was working so hard. I suggested it to him. You know, he war hero, a leader, a great, you know, he's an admiral, a great, great guy, 50 years old, and he started studying. And then he started getting hit with vicious rumors, vicious. And the Secret Service told me just coming in, sir, we checked out all of those things, sir. They're not true. They're not true. So they try and destroy a man. Well, they're doing it with us. They're trying their damnedest.
Now, two quick notes, Dana. These allegations come from more than 20 sources that have spoken to John Tester about Ronny Jackson, and further, multiple sources that have spoken to CNN and other media outlets. The White House produced some documents on Friday that attempted to contradict or at least push back some of these allegations, which, of course, Jackson has denied. We're still awaiting an explanation for why he's not going to return as the president's personal physician. We will let you know when we hear back, Dana.